इसका म्यूजिक कम करा दो ना, साथ में आएगा कोई पहले स्टार्ट करो।
अर्चना इसके अंदर म्यूजिक ऑफ। हां मैम,
कोई सामने देख लो। या
लेट मी नो व्हेन यू आर रेडी प्लीज। म्यूजिक ऑफ हो जाए।
कट कट मिल दे।
हेलो हेलो, कैन आई हैव सम वाटर?
या
चेक चेक। हेलो 1 2 1। हेलो 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 1 2 1। चेक चेक चेक। हेलो हेलो हेलो।
हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम। एंड दिस इज रीमा दास एंड आई एम द डायरेक्टर प्रोड्यूसर ऑफ विलेज रॉकस्टार्स। And you already know, and I'm really very excited to share that Village Rockstars, and this is the official entry this time for Oscars from India, and it's a very independent film. Like I started shooting probably 2014, and it took me 2013 onwards I started shooting this film, and it took me almost 4 years to finish the should I start from the beginning?
Okay,
because it will be difficult for me now. I think I'll start from the beginning. Yes. Welcome everyone, this is Reema Das. I'm the director producer of Village Rockstars, and you already know, and I'm very happy to be here and share my journey. And Village Rockstars now the official entry for Oscars from India, and yeah, it's like I don't know how to express my feelings, because it's a very independent film. Actually, I think 2013 we started our journey, and it took me almost 4 years to shoot this film. And it's a very independent film because we don't have a crew, and already that time I was doing my post production of my first film Manuda Binoculars. And during that time only I met these amazing children in my village in Assam, and the village name is called Choigaon Kaladia, and I was really inspired by these children and moved, and I thought I don't want to lose the opportunity to make a movie with these children, beautiful children. And I saw them performing in a local gathering with fake instruments, and I was so surprised to see that how they were enjoying, you know, they don't have resources, but still how they are celebrating life. And I'm living in Mumbai, it is couple of years, and See, I don't want to say like other people, but my journey here is like I was living quite a materialistic life, and when I was back in my village then and met these children and villagers, then looking at them how they are, the people think that they are poor, but I thought they are not, because yes, they are like they like poverty is there, but growing up with poverty and natural calamities, but still I can see the happiness, how they play with nature, and how they are in deprivation also, how they are celebrating life. And that is how Village Rocks started. And there was no like fund, that is the reason I had a camera, Canon 5D Mark II, and I just started like single-handedly. Then Mallika Das, my cousin sister, she helped me in every department, and it has been like a fairy tale journey for us, because like after that film, like it traveled so much. We opened in premiered in Toronto International Film Festival and 2017, that after that we almost I think traveled 80 festivals around the world, and we got national award for best feature film, including edit, best editing, child actor, then location sound. Mallika Das, she got location sound, then child artist Bhanita Das. Even Bhanita Das, she like got I think till now like 6 awards as an like a best actress. And till now we got around 44 hours, and finally we are here. I'm really I'm feeling so blessed, and it's a great day actually. It's like somewhere, because the film was traveling somewhere inside, I was praying and hoping that the might like it go to like a like as an Oscar entry from India, and finally we are there, and I'm speechless. Like I don't know how to express my feelings, and it's a huge recognition for us, because India is huge, so many languages, like competing with mainstream films, then they are selecting so very independent film is I think is a very good start for us. And so many new filmmakers and so many like film lovers, they keep writing to me that I inspire them, but honestly, like it was just my journey, just because I love cinema, so I started, and people keep asking me how hard it was the journey, but they keep asking me like what are the challenges I faced without a crew doing everything. I just want to share that like the journey was hard, it was challenging, but it is possible, and that belief, because of that we are here. Thank you.
Questions, please. What are the challenges that you faced while making the film, and did you know that it's going to be a proud moment for India and for our cinema to be showcased on the global front?
Actually, I mostly get this question that how hard it was. So anyone who making movies, I think they can understand how hard it is, because I was working with non-actors, non-professional, the whole like my cast, they are from my village, and it is hard, single-handedly handling the camera, casting, art, and when there is no lights, like I have to take care of the lights, and that is like in Assam, like it is very unpredictable weather, so most of the time like I had to shoot in the morning, early morning, or in the like late afternoon, because otherwise light is very harsh, I cannot shoot. And and we shot the film in a very like we shot rains, floods, like we covered so many things almost the whole season. And and mostly I faced like even like the children, they are having school, and I have to take care of that. And like all of it, like the conscious, like kind of a, when you are making a film with the non-professional actors, and I'm roaming in the village 4 years, like only one camera in my hand. So biggest challenge was to convince, you know, the parents that they used to think what she is doing, like it has been 4 years, like what she is, like she might be, she's spoiling our kids. Or but interestingly, I had to believe, like, you know, because I was studying, because I'm not from film school. So I was I watched so many movies like from around the world, and somewhere I had the belief that we are going to make it. And like, so that is the reason I used to tell my children that you are very special, and you just believe in me, and definitely we are going to make something like something happen. And I really, really am thankful to these children who trusted me, and their consistency. They stayed with me 4 years, and because I know what I'm doing, I love cinema, but for them, like, they are unknown, and still they believed in me. And because of their that innocence, I think, and they surrendered completely when I was making this film. Because of that, it's possible, I think. And when I like the film was in Toronto International Film Festival, that was my day, because I always dreamt to that my film goes to like top big festivals, Cannes, Berlin, Venice, like Toronto. And when Toronto selected, then I thought like, yeah, this is like kind of a I was very happy. And then also because the film, it don't have background score, the whole film. So I was like thinking like how film will be accepted in India. But surprisingly, when it opened in Mumbai Film Festival here, really like I was surprised that in India also people loved the film, they appreciated. And then we traveled to in India, like Kerala Film Festival, Goa IFFI, Dharamshala, Guwahati International Film Festival, Bangalore, and so many places, and always getting like so much positive response. And then I thought that yes, probably the film is accepted globally, because, and then I'm also traveling with the film so many festivals around the world. And and yes, like I wanted to, like I remember, like I was in Cannes and 2016 attending like Cannes Film Festival, my film Antardrishti Manuda Binoculars, it was there. And I did a marker screening, and that time I was there was a workshop I was attending, and then I don't remember his name, but he said that eat local and think global. And I also tried to with this Village Roxas, I tried to spread that universal human emotions, and I'm very happy that it touched people. Yeah, thank you.
Also, Assam government has announced some 50 lakhs for the promotion of the film.
Yes,
so
yes.
What would you like to say for that?
I'm very, very thankful that Assam government is supporting the film, giving 50 lakhs, and it's like, I think it's wonderful. And I think it will really help the film too, because we need a big promotion and campaign. And like because for everything, like for me also is very new, but still I am traveling last 3 years, several internationally festivals. So there are quite like good like well wishers with whom I can discuss. I can make the, you know, like how to show the film there, how to, like, because it's very important to release the film in US. So probably with this money, and probably we need more money, what I have heard. I'm speaking to like people, so let's see, like this amount definitely going to help us, but still I think we need more money, and this is a very, very independent film. We don't have any big studio backup. I'm the solo producer, and definitely I think we'll need more fund.
You know, Kakao is releasing the film, and it's
yes.
going to be seen in the theaters this Friday.
Right.
So, what do you have to
say
about
I'm really happy that I think, like, I remember, like, when I made this film, and people are, like, people watch in the festivals, but the common people, like, who really want to, people don't like attend film festivals, but there are many people, like, they tweet me, like, in Twitter, Facebook, like, mails, they keep calling me that they want to watch the film. And I'm really happy that after Mumbai festival only, PVR, they approached me. They said that they want to release the film, but I was also occupied. And finally, I really appreciate this approach, because PVR, they are doing this Wakao Pan India release on 28th September. And even we in Assam also, we are releasing around 40 to 50 theaters. So it will be great that you come to theater and watch our Village Rocksters, and I really look forward to hear your feedback, how you going to take this film. It's I'm just very hopeful, and I'm very thankful to PVR.
What do you expect now with the film is the official entrant this year?
Right.
So when you go back to Guwahati, which you are traveling soon to Assam, what is the kind of response that you're expecting? Because as you said, it was a 4 years journey, and you know they all were wondering what is happening. Reema's there with the camera. So what do you have to say about that?
Can you repeat?
What kind of response are you expecting from people in Assam? The actors, you know, the
Yeah, response, because like I have told that we are traveling a lot with the film, and it is not only in the festival, but there were few screenings in Guwahati also. There were two screenings. One is like Guwahati International Film Festival, and during the state hours, and all kind of people came from different age group, and response is really overwhelming. And it's very unexpected, because in Assam, like, always, like, we have a, like, complaint that people nowadays, they don't come to the theaters to watch film. And but surprisingly, like, when there was state awards and this Guwahati International Film Festival, there was long queue. People came, elderly people came, they stood because there was no space. They even were standing, like, for 2 hours almost, and sitting on the ground. And I cannot express my feelings. I'm really happy that there is something happening, you know. People are coming and they want to watch this film. And again, like, because I'm traveling so much, and there are many screenings for children also. And I thought, like, I honestly speaking, I actually want children to more and more watch, like, school children, or like even college students, because I think this film, I really want to, when I was making the film, this is not at all a structured film for children, you know. This is a very, there are many layers. This is about Dhunu, a small girl who dreams to own a guitar, and who lives in a village, and who is like a mother who always very supporting, although but there are many layers in the film. It is not like So then I was thinking, like, how the children going to respond this film, like. But I'm really surprised that when I was traveling in India also, we were in Children Film Festival Hyderabad, there was a screening in Delhi also, and Munich, Paris, then London, and the children are getting so much. I'm very curious, and I really children to watch this film a lot, yeah, more and more.
Even last question, is Bollywood on your mind now?
It's nothing like that. I just like, I want to Village Rock, I like Man with the Binoculars, it was a different film. Village Rocks, I tried different, like with Bulbul Can Sing, we just premiered in Toronto. And in September, our world premiere, now we are going to Busan International Film Festival. So all three films, I feel like I tried something different, and challenging myself. And I'm living in Mumbai quite a couple of years, and I feel like, yes, because I came here to become an actor. And somewhere I feel like I know Bombay. I like to make movies where I know the people, I know the place, the culture. So that's the reason. Bollywood, I don't know, but definitely I would love to make a film in Hindi. And music, I love music. Like, it's not that I don't love, like in Village Oxus and in Bulbul Can Sing, music is everywhere. So why not? Maybe I would love to try. Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Thank you.